missing sub-attribute country, sub-attribute of shipping issue. Are you facing that latest issue that's been rolled out by Google? So Google has rolled out recently from the April 27 onwards, they have updated the Google Merchants guidelines to want you to submit more specific information if you're using this attribute shipping. This is how it looks like if you have seen this error. In this video, I'm going to explain to you exactly what is this attribute issue, what are you facing, and what you can do to resolve it so you can get all your products approved and shown on Google Shopping. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. If you're new to this channel, you might also want to check out my other videos that's related to this video. It's the recent announcement to Google Merchant Center on product identifiers. You can check out this video right here so you don't have product identifiers issue. Or if you have availability date issue coming up that's being announced as well, you can check out my Google availability date settings on how to set it up correctly so your products will not be penalized by Google and you can continue to get free traffic from Google Shopping listings. To make sure that you get your products and your Google Merchants account approved, you want to really understand a bit more about Google and their business objectives. Essentially, Google wants you as the merchant to be providing the most accurate, the most amount of information available for customers to make the right choice so that they can trust you and they want to buy from you. As long as you fulfill those criteria or those information that Google has requested, there is no reason why your products will be disapproved. Google's ultimate long-term objective is they want shoppers or customers to think of going to Google Shopping when they want to buy a product rather than choosing to go to Amazon right now to do their product research. In order for that to happen, Google is constantly updating their guidelines for Google Merchant Center to make sure that you, as the store owner, continues to provide the most amount of information needed for them to provide Google users a great shopping experience. What is this missing sub-attribute country issue about? Essentially, this has to do with this attribute called shipping. Shipping is a very important piece of information that Google wants you to be providing, whether it is how much it costs for people to ship a product if they buy a certain specific product, like if your shipping cost is based on the weight and size, based on the amount that you spend, Google wants that all to be really transparent, and also how much time does it take for the product to eventually arrive at your customer's door, from the handling, the processing, like how long does the customer have to wait? You have to provide all of this information to Google so Google can show all this correct information to the customers. So customers will not get a shock. They want to see some form of consistency so they can trust you. If they click on your product that's showing on Google Shopping and they see a different shipping prices or shipping delivery time that's different on Google Shopping and your store, then they're going to feel that they're going to be cheated. So there's no trust. And Google wants to work together with you to provide this trust and transparency. So you have to read Google's guidelines really carefully to make sure you don't have this error. And the basis of this missing attribute, missing sub-attribute country, essentially under the shipping attribute itself, there is a certain number of information that you need to provide. There is up to 4 pieces of information you can provide in this shipping column, and one of it is compulsory. It's because you haven't provided the information itself, country, in this particular attribute, which is the compulsory value, then that's why it's throwing up this error. It might sound a bit fluff to you right now, but I'm going to show you more details when we head onto the computer so I can show you exactly what is the expected format and value that you should be submitting to Google.
Now we are on the Google Merchant Center help page. This shows the latest product data spec update announced on April 27th. And what we want to talk about today is the provide shipping country sub-attribute update. There are some stores which have been affected by this update because you are using the shipping attribute. That means that there is a certain information you need to provide when sending the shipping attribute update to Google Merchant Center. So you need to provide a country to make sure that the shipping prices are accurate. Typically, this error happens on the product or item level. So there'll be individual products that Google will tell you what's happening to them. You'll be able to see more of this information when you go to the diagnostics page on your Google Merchant Center to look at specific products, like what are the issues. Usually I would recommend you as a store owner not to use this attribute where possible. Try to minimize the complexity of shipping costs or handling costs as much as possible. You can update all of this in the settings page on the shipping setup at the top right hand corner of your Google Merchant Center. However, because you might be offering different products and there are certain products that you have to take into account the weight of the products, so the shipping cost could be based on the weight or the dimensions of your product, and it might cost you more to send to the customers, so you might need to use this attribute. You have to make sure your information is all fully filled up. So I want to show you what you can do specifically to address this issue. If your shipping cost is determined by either the weight of your product or the dimensions of your product, and you put in this information in Shopify store, if you have a Shopify store, or if you have a WooCommerce store, then you need to head to the individual level shipping on the shipping field of the individual product as you put in the weight of the product. So remember to check this box, shipping, check this box, this is a physical product. For any products eligible to be on Google Shopping, Google has clearly outlined that any products need to be a physical product. So you need to make sure that this is a physical product in order for the shipping cost to be calculated as well. So make sure this box is checked. Once you have checked the box and you have put down the weight, if you're using weight or the dimensions, then save this information, and this information will be automatically synced up to Google Merchant Center if you have set up an automated shopping feed. If you're using more complex methods of calculating your shipping and delivery turnaround time, then this is the attribute information you need to click on and learn more about. Let's click here and find out. Perfect. Now we are on this shipping information page. Google has outlined what is the information needed. So although this is a single attribute, okay, you need to put in multiple pieces of information that summarizes the shipping speed of how long the product will take to arrive on your customer's doorstep and what's the total cost of getting this product, excluding the sales price. So in this case, Google has outlined that if you need to override your shipping settings for specific products that are bulky or fragile in nature, then this will be the attribute for you to use to override the general cost. And Google has also clearly define what does it mean by shipping costs charged by a carrier or other costs directly related to shipping. So if it's anything to do with handling, delivery, any logistics, and the delivery company that you're using, or if it includes any cross-border charges, all of these falls under shipping costs. And if there's any insurance cost, shipping costs should also take that into consideration. Of course, shipping costs also includes like how fast you're going to take, like regular shipping costs, or if they want it to be next day delivery, quicker delivery time, so maybe there's additional cost. So you want to add that to the customers when the customers want the product as quickly as possible. And you need to also put in the handling time, when the order is being placed to when it's being fulfilled. So you want to put all of this information under shipping speed and cost. One of the reasons why Google really prioritizes it is the users or buyers use shipping costs and delivery speed to be one of their top decision makers. Like if they find that it's too expensive for the product to ship to them compared to other stores, or if it's taking too long for the product to arrive, then they might change to a different store. So they want you to make sure that you are providing the most accurate, up-to-date information to help increase the performance of your ads and free listings. that is to help the customers to decide to want to buy your products. So if you're offering better shipping services or lower, more competitive costs, then it's going to greatly help you. So let's look at the other way to resolve this issue, which is the missing sub-attribute country issue. So let's take a look in depth what are these various sub-attributes under this shipping attribute. So under shipping attribute, these are the various sub-attributes. So within a single column or single field, you have to put in country, so which country that this product is being delivered to, so that could be different costs. So you have to put in the country, which is a required compulsory field, and the delivery area that could go down to region, postal code, if you have different pricing for different areas. So you can put in all of this information, a location ID, as you can see, all of this optional information. Unless you are offering really specific competitive prices, like lower prices, to go down to like specific postal code area or location ID, then I suggest you just leave all of this alone, mainly because it's quite complex. So if you're doing it wrongly, then that's not going to look good on your store. And of course, if you're using a specific service class, like first class delivery or second class, so the speed, you can also put that in. This information is optional. And the price, so if Google has mentioned you're using this attribute specially to override your general pricing cost, specific cost that takes into account maybe the weight and fragility. You need to pay a little bit more, so you want to work that exception into your price. This will be the pricing that you use. You can use a fixed shipping cost, you can use like full stop, just period, and the currency. Don't use commas. You can also put in the handling time, which is an optional field, like how much time does it take, minimum and maximum amount of time. So typically I would say don't underestimate the handling time. I'll put in the average and then give a good maximum handling time where possible to manage your customers' expectation. And there is also the transit time. So this is how the attribute is going to look like. So let's take a look. So for example, if you want to submit the shipping field, then inside shipping, you will put in the postal code. So you can put in the country, colon, postal code, colon, price, minimum handling time, colon, maximum handling time. This is the format and the order which this information should be submitted. If you want to fill in all of this information, if you don't specify the specific sub-attribute, country, region, service, and price, then you need to specifically put it in this order, which is the country first, the region, service, and price. And then you format the value by submitting the value of each of these sub-attribute. As you can see, these four sub-attributes here in the same order, separated with a colon. Okay. So for example, if you are submitting it, if you're shipping to the US, you put the US, and then you put a colon sign, and then there's the postal code 80302, you put colon, which is the postal code that you are doing. And then the price, 6.49 with the USD, the correct currency code that you should put in. You need to look it up before you put it in. And then you put the colon sign, which is the minimum handling time, maximum handling time, which is 1, 2, 3. And transit time is 2 to 5 days. So there's 1 to 3 days and there's 2 to 5 days. If let's say you are transporting the product to maybe the US and Canada and it's the exact same pricing and the same minimum handling time, you still need to submit two different sets of values, one with the US and one with Canada. So even though the rest of the pricing and the time, turnaround time is the same, you still need to put in the country to differentiate the different pricing at country level. So this is a compulsory value. So make sure all of this is submitted correctly.
Now you know exactly what's the error about and which is the correct information you need to submit to Google. I hope you can fix that in your automated feed. I always encourage online store owners to set up automated feed so they don't have to worry about the product. If there are any changes, all of this information will be automatically updated in Google Merchant. If you are doing it manually, then you might want to set up some kind of refresh, data refresh, So the correct information will always be shown on Google Merchant Center. The best way to make sure you don't get these issues, I highly recommend, is to simplify your shipping costs. If you just have a small store and you have a certain number of products, make sure you calculate your shipping costs to make sure that your products or business continues to be sustainable. Keep it as simple as possible. If you set up like the minimal shipping all in the Google Merchant Center settings under shipping and returns, if you provide all the correct shipping information, if you just put it right there, then you don't have to complicate your life by having to submit individual attribute values for each of your products. I find that really complicated. I mean, unless you're a really big store like Microsoft or Oracle where you sell thousands of products and variants, then maybe that would make sense because maybe there are specific products with certain specific rules. Then you might actually want to adjust that specifically for individual products for your shipping costs or shipping settings. However, if you're only selling certain product categories and there's not much difference in shipping costs, maybe you just want to standardize your shipping costs. For example, having a standard fees for your in-country shipping and then like a standardized cost for shipping internationally. Especially if your products are all of a similar size, don't complicate your life by messing up your product feed. Just update it in the Merchant Center settings, set it up based on maybe local or international, or you can set up based on a certain weight limit. You can set up like 2 to 3 different costs, shipping costs for the weight differences, and then you stick to a specific courier methods so that it will be really standard and you don't have to worry about submitting individual attribute values under the shipping column attribute. If you want slightly more guidance on how to set up shipping settings exactly, I have my other video right here where I explain how you can set it up if you're doing free shipping or if you have a specific cost. And if you want to drive more traffic to your store without running ads as well, I have another video which you can check out, drive traffic without running ads. So you can check that out as well. You can explore different options of how to drive traffic to your store. So it's good to not just focus on getting just traffic from Google. I highly recommend you to diversify your traffic source so you're not highly dependent on Google. You can also drive traffic through other sources, so it helps to reduce your reliance and risk just by focusing on that one channel. And if you want to explore a more exhaustive list of driving traffic to your site, you can check out my Shopify marketing guide where I go into the pros and cons of different ways of driving traffic to your store. You can check that out right there in the description and pinned comments. Link is right there. And if you require more specific help to run shopping ads, whether it is to grow a blog or YouTube channel, to grow your brand and get more traffic and sales in the long-term strategy, check out my contact form in the description and pinned comments as well. I help Shopify store and other online store owners to get more traffic and sales in the middle to long term, so your store will continue to be more profitable and sustainable in the long run. If you found this video useful, remember to give it a like, subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss future videos on how to get more traffic and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page 1. I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI Doctor, signing off. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. I'm not the one who's always right.